It's unbelievable. I keep trying to do my video for today, and I'm set on silent mode, and three times now the phone has rung during me trying to film. I just don't get it. Let's start fresh here. Hi, everybody. It's Tuesday, December 6th. I wanted to start off, first off, by just saying I was really sad to hear of the passing of Kirstie Alley. It seems like almost every day now, you're almost afraid to listen to the news. So many people have passed, and that came as quite a surprise. Apparently, she had just been recently diagnosed with cancer, and I guess it must have been pretty virulent because it took her out pretty quick, as far as at least the press release goes. It's been so hard every day. Every time I open up my Facebook page, all I see is people posting about their pets passing. You know, it's hard. Boy, it's so hard when you lose a dog or a cat or whatever you've chosen as your companions. And, you know, seeing these people posting pictures of their dogs and stuff and just, you know, how the sadness of it all. It's just every day you just kind of, wow, you know, it just gets hard. On a little more positive note, tomorrow we'll be doing the clubhouse. I meant to announce this the other day, and we got real bogged down with Aspen doing the film festival and the gig up there, and Cooch and Waddy got nailed with altitude issues up there. It was really, but I talked to Cooch last night and Waddy, and they're doing fine now. They feel good. It's just got back to sea level, so thank goodness for that. Because we are at the Coach House this coming Thursday, and then at the Mint on, I believe, Saturday. So looking forward to playing again. It'll be the last couple of gigs of the year for us. I've got album work to do, but those will be the last live gigs of the year. So Clubhouse live stream tomorrow. As the old saying goes, be there or be square. I believe Aaron is sending out info on that. I'm going to go and visit an artist who I've talked about in the past, and this is a different album that I worked on with him, so I was going to just address this this one song on it. But that's the great Shawn Phillips. Shawn is unlike almost any other artist I've ever worked with in this business, and every time I've gotten a call from him, I just go, yeah, this is going to be something special. So I'm going to read you just a little bio stuff here. His bio is extensive. So if you find this intriguing, then just pull up Shawn Phillips. Just Google him up and it's check Wikipedia. But it says Shawn Phillips was born February 3rd, 1943 as an American singer, songwriter, and musician. Primarily influential in the 60s and 70s, his work is rooted in folk rock, but straddles other genres, including jazz fusion and funk. Phillips has recorded 26 albums. I think I've worked on about four of them, and worked with musicians including Donovan, Paul Buckmaster, J. Peter Robinson, Eric Clapton, Steve Winwood, Bernie Taupin, Tim Hardin. List goes on and on. Rock impresario Bill Graham describes the Texas-born musician, or described him, that's another one that's gone, as the best-kept secret in the music business. His refusal to pigeonhole his music, which seamlessly melds folk rock, jazz, funk, progression, progressive, pop, electro, classical, and global folk traditions to meet anyone else's expectations, allowed him to retain his cult following without ever achieving the stardom that his talent seemed to merit. Let's see. Yeah, it's just all kinds of stuff here. Let me see. Phillips was born in Fort Worth, as I said, the son of James Attlee Phillips, writer of spy novels under the pseudonym of Philip Attlee, and nephew of CIA officer Philip Attlee Phillips, David Attlee Phillips. He grew up in various locations around the world, including Tahiti, and learned to play guitar as a child. He returned to live in Texas in the late 50s, and after a time in the U.S. Navy, moved to California. He played folk clubs in the early 60s alongside singer-songwriter Tim Hardin, comedian Lenny Bruce, and others, and when in Saskatoon, Canada, where my Dingwall basses are made, met and taught guitar technique to an aspiring singer, Joni Anderson, later to be Joni Mitchell. He recorded his first single, an adaptation of Bob Gibson's version of Frankie and Johnny, in 64. While traveling to India, he stopped in London to meet record producer Dennis Preston, who signed him to Columbia Records. Phillips released two albums on the label, I'm a Loner and Shawn, though neither was successful. During this period, also met Donovan. The pair ultimately collaborated on several songs, including Season of the Witch, for which Phillips, though uncredited, composed the melody. Phillips also appears on several of Donovan's albums, including Fairy Tale, Sunshine Superman, Mellow Yellow. Through Donovan, he met the Beatles and contributing background vocals on Lovely Rita. It goes, God, it's amazing, goes on. In 67, he left England after his work permit expired, and after a period in Paris, moved to Positano, Italy, while continuing to tour. He returned to England to write and perform with the Gin, the music for the controversial Jane Arden play, Vagina Rex and the Gas Oven at the Arts Laboratory on Drury Lane in London of 69. Sponsored by Dick James, he also recorded material with Steve Winwood, Jim Capaldi, and Chris Wood of Traffic. God, I mean, there's so much about this guy. It's just crazy. He continued to tour and secure standing ovations for his impromptu solo performances at the 1970 Isle of Wight Festival. He was also approached to be the lead in the Broadway production of Jesus Christ Superstar and started rehearsing the show, but withdrew because of contractual disagreements with the show's producer, Robert Stigwood. According to Bruce Eder at AllMusic, in the 70s recordings, his 70s recordings established his reputation for boundless, nearly peerless creativity and virtuosity, 12-string guitar combined with 4-octave vocal range. Writers lavished praise on Phillips for his unusual lyrics, haunting melodies, daunting musicianship, and ambition on his records. He was a complete enigma, American-born but raised internationally, with foreign keen appreciation of all the music of his homeland and a seasoned traveler's love of world music, and none of the usual limits on his thinking about music. Phillips never achieved major stardom despite his critical accolades. He never courted the obvious commercial sound, preferred to work on songs that, he's put it, makes you feel different from the way you felt before you started listening, primarily love songs and sonic landscapes. It goes on and... Sorry, let me just... he also, I mean, one of the things that was remarkable, beyond his music, he was also an EMT. So he got into working in saving lives, basically. And he says, one of my EMT calls was an 89-year-old woman named Clara who had fractured her pelvis from stepping out of bed too hard. I took a great deal of care to keep her from suffering before we transferred to Austin EMS. I said to her, we're going to give you over to these guys, but you're in very good hands. She was very frightening. As I left, she grabbed me by the arm, looked me in the eyes, and said, thank you so much for taking care of me. And the music business just disappeared into the distance. I got a double standing ovation in front of 657,000 people at the Isle of Wight Festival in 1970. You can imagine that rush. But the moment with Clara was much more powerful because the work is immediate. It's as real as you can get. Before moving to Louisville, Kentucky in 2016, with his wife Juliet and their 12-year-old son Liam, named after his younger brother Phillips, lived in Italy and South Africa. Phillips' uncle, David Attlee Phillips, was a top CIA officer who was associated with the alleged assassination of Lee Harvey Oswald. I mean, it just goes on and on and on about this guy, a really amazing guy. And he's got that Texas drawl when you talk to him. It's really amazing. But on this one, this album that I did with him was from 1972, and it's called Faces. And the track that I did with him was called Hey Miss Lonely, and it's myself, Ed Morin, on drums, and Sneaky Pete Kleinow on steel guitar. Sneaky Pete's another one of those fascinating people. He's like the one of the most interesting steel players I ever knew, but beyond that, he was also a special effects guy. And for anybody that ever saw Terminator with Schwarzenegger, when the truck crashes and he's burned up in it, and then the skeleton of him comes out, this stainless steel skeleton, Sneaky Pete designed that skeleton. Interesting. Casts of characters on these things is really amazing. This was, let's see, which track is that one? That's number three. So this was engineered by Robert A. Pear, who did our early section albums, and we did Neil Sedaka together, all kinds of stuff. We cut this at Clover Recorders, which was Robert's studio down on Santa Monica Boulevard, produced by Jonathan Weston. I think that's about all the information I have on it. So I'm going to go ahead and play this track. And here we go. Shawn Phillips, amazing cat. I would have used Peace Love on that. That was pre-Frankenstein, so that would have been that same bass I used on Doctor My Eyes and Stratus and all of James's early stuff. My old Peace Love 62 jazz bass. Yeah, it was interesting with Shawn too. Shawn has, I probably still has it, had like waist-length blonde hair, just this beautiful mane of hair. And I believe when he was living in Positano, he was out on a little boat fishing and got his hair caught in the outboard motor, and it almost scalped him. And he had to work his way back to shore to get to a hospital to have everything stitched back together again. But when I heard about that, that was really some scary shit. It's unbelievable. But I mean, I've seen him many times since then, and he's fine. But boy, when an accident like that happens, boy, you get around power tools, things can go bad real fast. So you got to be really careful. Okay, I'm going to get running here. I got a lot to do today. But I'm just going to remind you that, again, tomorrow will be the clubhouse. So those of you that can make it, I look forward to seeing you. I always enjoy that so much. And I know there's going to be a whole group of you at the Coach House and probably the Mint, too. So it's going to be fun to catch up and see everybody. So take good care. Have a great day. And just think about your family and friends. Boy, time can be fleeting. You don't want to miss a moment if you can possibly help it. So take good care, and I'll see you tomorrow. Okay, bye-bye.